Happy Taplon Tuesday, everyone. I'm not actually in Taplon anymore. I've moved on to the next town. But that's the only thing related to this game I can think of that starts with T. Tokyo Tower Tuesday. Alright, save the game. And let's check the diary. Wow, 3 new entries just for that one episode. Alright.
We just arrived at a place called Rosen. Amazingly, Faria was there playing a flute near the entrance. I was happy to see him, but Fu was a little rude. I wonder why she gives him such a hard time. We ran into Faria in the snowy village of Rosen. Fu was mean to him, but only because she secretly likes him. You see, he was playing his flute for other girls, not her. I wish she'd just admit that he melts her butter and get it over with.
The village of Rosen has a very cold climate and strong winds. The people here say that it used to be quite different. I wonder what made the weather here change so drastically. Oh well, nothing else of note happened.
While staying at a hotel, Umi woke me up in the middle of the night and called me to the window. We saw people walking around outside in the freezing cold. We couldn't figure out where they were going, so we'll ask the hotel owner.
A sound during the night woke me up. I went to the window and saw lots of men going somewhere outside, but I couldn't tell where they were headed. What's going on in this frozen freak show? I must know! Oh well, maybe we'll find out soon. Hikaru promised to ask the hotel staff.
I was just entering a deep REM sleep when Umi woke me up suddenly. She took me to the window, where I saw lots of men from the village sneaking out of their houses and congregating somewhere out of sight. I wonder if Faria was with them.
We found a suspicious cave in the snow. When we entered, we discovered Faria inside. He offered to help us, but Fu protested. What is her problem?
I am so upset with Fu. She shouldn't have said such hurtful things to Faria. I mean, I understand how she feels. She obviously likes him, but she doesn't know what to do with her feelings. Poor Faria.
Something must be terribly wrong with me. I don't seem to have control of my emotions anymore. It's very disconcerting. I don't like it one bit.
It must be some sort of mysterious dark magic from Zaygot that's making Fu act that way. There's no other explanation, really. Well, happy Frozen Freak Show Friday, everyone. It's too bad I'm not playing this on a Friday. Onward. Action time. Hell yeah. We get this music again. That was a lot of hits. But it is a snail. Gotta get through that tough shell. You know, this cave looks and sounds suspiciously like the last cave. Oh, this thing's dividing. Well, Ooze arrows are just the thing for this sort of abomination. Stop. Oh no! That's an actual hole. I mean, obviously it's a hole. It's a hole that you can fall down and get hurt, not just an invisible barrier. I wonder if that will be true of all the holes in this place. Alright. Hey, buddy. Paul Dina! Can't open it from the side. Yellow rainbow amulet. Awesome. Let's see how I'm doing. One red, two yellow, and a purple, and that's it. Ah. So that's... What is that sound? Was that part of the music before? Anyway, this is the Pokeball that contains my dragon. Or Umi's dragon. Yeah, this is all hazardous terrain. Only for the primary character, though. The other two characters can float above it just like they always do. Uh-oh. A Helivator. That's kind of cool how the bottom layer fades out like that. Gasp! Water sharks! A more deadly variety of the traditional land shark, no doubt. Hey, friends. Nope. I should probably give the other characters some help. Have a heart, Hikaru. I expect that'll be magic spell for Hikaru over to the west there, that mirror. So I'm probably going to have to use her soon. But not yet. So is the music going to do the little wow 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 thing again? No? Last time it did it right before it looped. Very strange. Oh, there it goes. That must not be part of the music. That must be something in the environment. Maybe it was the sharks. Ah! I don't want to take any chances here. No magic. All right, Hikaru is off exploring somewhere. Oh. Okay, this is swimmable water. Hi, Hikaru. Okay, so I can hop up here. That would seem to be a teleporter. But it's up on top of the thing. Oh, okay. Just a normal transporter. Treasure. Awesome. Yeah, there's nothing in the rainbow shop that doesn't require at least one of every color, so always happy to see a new color pop up. Oh, it's like these enemies were made for Fu. You can split? So can my arrows. Oh god. Some sort of bubble blowing jester slime monster. That's a really cool monster design. That arrow is just gonna kind of circle around uselessly, huh? Yeah, have some magic, Foo. More healing ability is probably the most important thing I can focus on right now. Hello? What's all this then? Well, I guess I gotta get up there. As the great poet said, I have to get up to go down. Okay, I think this is the monster making that sound. Ow. I think it's supposed to be like some sort of electrical aura sound, but it just sounds like someone going wah, 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 into the microphone. Alright, so can I get up here and not step on this thing? No, it's gonna force me, huh? No? Okay, I can just sort of cheat my way around it. That's nice. But this still isn't part of the grand contraption. Can I jump that? Okay. I don't know if this is what I'm supposed to be doing. I mean, it put that conveyance there to convey me, but it didn't seem to be steerable in any way. I've already been here, right? Yeah. My party has abandoned me. Oh wait, there they are. They're just in another dimension at the moment. I mean, it is nice that they took the extra effort to draw the other two characters on the screen, even if it is a little bit silly. I don't know, maybe that thing can be steered. Well, the one I stepped on was a different one. Let's try this one. I'm pushing the D-pad in other directions, and it doesn't seem to be doing much. But I saw character portrait, man. Hello. Very helpful. Orange. So I'm missing B and I. Blue and indigo. Wow, that's obnoxious. Come on, character portrait man. I know you're important. Ah. I don't know if not writing that thing is intended. Okay. Maybe I need to learn the charge ability first to make that jump. Alright, I don't have to jump there. Well, let's try writing it back and then hold up at that junction. But I didn't really do that before. Oops. I mean, I held directions, but I don't know if I held that one. Junction! No. No junction. Hi, Hikaru. Alright, well, which of these directions have I not been? I've been over here. Yeah. Well, now that Hikaru's here for moral support, and Umi, it's just a matter of time until I crack the code. Oh. That bubble pop sound was real satisfying. Alright. I need to... Ooh. Wait. Oh, okay. So I need to get in the water and then swim up into the east. Alright, so how can I accomplish that? Well, that's just a very, very long way back where I've already been. I can't just fall? Come on, you let me fall in the hole. That's Bupkis. Yeah, it's definitely that monster that's responsible for that noise. Uh-oh. Heal thyself, Fu. In English, it sounds a little bit like I'm saying the word fool with a dropped L in a Mr. T-like fashion, but I assure you that is not the case. Boo is no fool. And when she is, it's because she's being controlled by sinister influences. Well, I found the way I came in. I might as well mosey over to the fountain and get my stuff back. If it's not... Oh, it's right here. Good deal. Alright. Once more into the breach. Well, at least there's no snow in this cave. Hello, what have we here? There's a contraption. Can I shoot it from here? No. Can't shoot it from here. Okay. Oh, so that'll open those gates, which will probably change the direction that the conveyance moves. I see. So I need to figure out how to access it. And that just sort of loops back around. Okay. Ah. Thought I found something there. I'm trying to let's go. Alright, well, I got that treasure chest, but did I miss something else? Excuse me, I'm trying to solve the puzzle. If you don't mind. Hey! Alright, buddy. I'm sick of your antics. Thank you for some money. Okay, so those are still closed. Oh, do I need to put out these fires? That would probably be the wind magic, right? Okay. Those might be non-decorative fires, no? Well, I don't have any sort of, mass ice spell. But of course, wait, didn't Umi... Oh no, it was Hikaru who got her second magic spell. Okay, so that mirror is for Umi. So once I get that, I need to come back here and put out those fires. Okay, well that's one piece of the puzzle solved. I mean solved, but not completed. Alright, so I need to find the mirror. Mirror, mirror, in the cave. In what direction do you lay? Yeah, that wasn't bad. Ah. Okay, well that's how I get to that. Oh, Claudina! Oh, must dig for Caldina. Blue. All right. So all I need is indigo, and I can get something. I'm assuming that shop isn't an actual shop, and it's just. I'll just have to prove that I collected them to get treats. I feel like I've been here and this was nothing. Yeah, I mean it was something, but I already got it. Alright, I kinda don't wanna hop on that conveyance again, but I figure whatever I missed is in that direction. Yeah, I talked to those people, for sure. Alright. I don't like walking around with no health. Alright, I need to make my way back to the water. Because there's definitely a thing up there. It might not be a plot critical thing, but it's a thing that I want to get. Hikaru and Umi slacking off like usual. Well, crud. Okay, well, that is a dead end. The alien noise must be scrambling their brains. Alright, that's the one I couldn't jump across. Alright, so I do think I need to walk as opposed to ride to get where I need to go. Like, I think that was an intentional thing. Alright, yeah. I wanted to work my way back to where the other conveyance was. I believe herein lies the solution. Ah, that just takes me back on top of this thing. Okay. Okay, I know what to do. Alright, so I could have just gone that way instead of riding that platform. Good to know. Alright, come on. I've been going for 25 minutes. I need to make some sort of progress. I'd like to get to that fountain. Alright. Ah, that just circles back around to there. Ah, this maze is like a labyrinth. One might call it labyrinthine. Alright, is there any other reason to ride this? Well, at least I get to listen to this awesome music. Alright, this just dead ends here. How did I get into the water that first time? I know this is so frustrating to watch, I'm so sorry. Sense of direction has never been my strong suit in video games. No map. Alright, I need to get back to wherever I was able to walk onto, like, that scaffolding. That's not the right word for it, but, like, the broken platforms in the water. Because there was a similar, not broken, but you know, like a platform in sections. Do I need to use magic on that thing? Let's use, I think, this one. Nope. Facing the wrong direction. Face that way. Okay. I didn't think that would be the solution that I wanted to try. Alright, I thought that other tube might lead somewhere else. Ah! Oh, if only I had known how important it was to be in the water. I should have explored that more thoroughly. But you know, swimming sucks. I didn't want to have to either mash buttons or turn on rapid fire. But I should have. Alright, I want to throw in the towel for this episode. Sorry for how circuitous and non-progress this episode was. Tune in tomorrow when I hopefully figure out where the hell I'm going. See you later.